Are you a person of faith, of religion, any?
Yes. Because
somebody who grew up here.
Yes.
Who had the same adversity that you did would have a chip on his shoulder and be not a nice person about it and come out of it with, what's wrong with you? You know, pull yourself up by your bootstraps. It's not that hard. It's slap out of it. No crying in baseball. That kind of attitude. Yeah. Yeah. You seem very humble and nice, even though you've come through this adversity where people from the Western world, I think, who went through the same amount of adversity would end up grinchy, old, grumpy, angry, resentful. You seem very well balanced and very humble about your experience. How do you manage that?
Thank you for that question, and that thank you for those kind words. So that humility comes from the fact that I, at the end of this all, at the end of this whole journey, upon reflection, I realize how much luck has to do with a lot of what I've been able to achieve. So,
really?
Yes. So I started out in the village. I started out the primary school I talked about, there were two classes in this primary school. So starting out, I was one of 60 children, 60 children that started primary school and went through that and middle school. And by the time we got to the end of middle school, I was the only one left standing. I write about this brilliant boy classmate of mine called Francis in the book. And I was with him for many years in those primary middle schools, and he's one of the most brilliant. He has one of the most brilliant minds I've ever met anywhere. And this when I was preparing for the admission to secondary school, he was the only one that actually also decided to apply because we were best friends, and he saw me doing this, and he decided he would go along and do that as well. So he also got admission to secondary school, but never got the opportunity because the scholarship I qualified for, because my father was a cocoa farmer. Cocoa is it used to be the leading export crop for Ghana.
And New Mexico.
Yes. Yeah. So as a cocoa farmer, the son of that cocoa farmer, I qualified for that scholarship. My friend wasn't so lucky. And so when I went off to secondary school, he remained in the village. And his brilliant mind, I mean, never got to be used. And so I went to secondary school, left to go study in the Soviet Union, and later on came to America and acquired all these degrees. And he has always been left in the village. And so when I think about him, really not a day goes by, you know, without me thinking about, you know, that friend of mine. And the other kids in my, you know, schools in the village were similarly talented. I mean, they weren't academically, but they were gifted athletes, musicians, all kinds of talents that never got anywhere. So the fact that I was the only one that made it out of the village told me that, you know, as people, there's so many forces, you know, that drive what we are able to do in this world. And some people never get those lucky breaks they need just to take them from one point to another. So although I've been able to achieve big things, I never lose sight of the fact that there was a heavy dose of luck involved in you know, my escape from that environment. And so that's what keeps me grounded.
Interesting perspective on it, because I'm thinking as you're talking, I'm thinking about, yes, there were breaks that came your way that were unexpected, but there were also bad breaks that came your way that if you would have given up and could have given up at any time, those wouldn't have been made possible. And it's really this idea of what separates people who have the tenacity and perseverance in the face of deep struggles that put themselves in a position for luck or whatever you want to call it to play a hand, good luck. Because I can look at it and say, there was a lot of bad luck. You just ignored the bad luck and just were focused on the good luck. And how do you develop that kind of mindset? I think if we could bottle that and figure it out, we would save half humanity.
Coffee with a Dog. Weekdays, 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time.